Hello, Darren.
Hi, Darren.
I thought today we could try some very short drawing exercises that were which I did at art college, and I thought maybe the viewers at home might also want to try it with us.
Good idea.
Okay, so I've set my camera up slightly differently. I'm going to draw this. I'm going to draw a Civil War, English Civil War teapot. There's Charles I. There's Cromwell and various battles on the lid.
Marvellous. Well, I'm drawing a Civil War PlayStation controller.
Yes. Sir, do you stand for Parliament or country?
Oh, God.
Actually, it's not what country. No. What do they say? King or country is what they say, don't they? Do you stand for king or country?
Country.
Yeah. I think that's the way, isn't it? Especially on a day like today. Right. Okay, then. So what we're going to do is we're going to draw the object in front of us. I don't suppose it'll take long. Let's maybe say 5 or 10 minutes, see how we go.
Probably.
Because I suppose, actually, because of the nature of the exercise, we don't really know how well we're doing. And what we're going to do is, I think it's often called automatic drawing, isn't it called?
I call it blind contour drawing.
Let's call it blind contour drawing. That sounds better. We are going to keep our eye on the teapot and the Civil War controller.
Yep.
And we are going to try and not look at a paper. It's a little hard for me. I think it might be easier for you because my head's about, it's about there. And so you're going to have to take it on trust a little bit because I'm sort of aware of the paper because obviously they're only that close, but I can kind of focus on that. You're just going to have to take a bit on trust. Maybe even that helps, actually, if I pull them apart a bit. So... yeah, we will never look at the paper. So I guess the problem is, let's find out what the problems are, shall we? Shall we start?
Yes, let's go for it. Yeah. Okay, we're off. Oh, this is a long time since I've done this.
One thing that's immediately interesting to me is that normally when I draw, I don't have bifocals, even though I possibly should.
Right.
So what I'm often doing is I have my glasses kind of half off my nose. And I'm trying to work out.
Right,
Because I need them to look at the paper. But I don't need them to look at the object. So I've now taken my glasses off. Oh, it's very tempting, isn't it? I'm already...
it's really difficult.
I'm trying to fight my instinct.
Yeah, I've not looked, but I really want to. I used to do this all the time when I was drawing like buildings and stuff, and portraits, actually.
What do you suppose, because I was trying to think about this before we came on air, what do you suppose the value is of... this exercise? It's all very well saying they made me do it at art college, but now I'm thinking, well, fine, why?
I think it teaches you to get used to draw whilst looking at the subject and not the page. And of course, the trick is that when you're actually doing a drawing that you intend to use, unlike this exercise, you get used to, you do some of your drawing looking at the subject and you glance down occasionally and it's teaching you to trust your hand and trust that your hand will follow what your eye is telling it. With practice, you will do a lot of drawing where you're not really looking at the page that much.
Yeah, do you suppose that is one of the lessons, that we look at the page sometimes and we're not looking up at the thing? We're sort of drawing,
yeah,
as we've discussed before, you're sometimes drawing what you think or you remember. Yeah. Of it being, or you think,
that's right,
you draw what you think a teapot looks like rather than actually.
Yes, exactly. Shapes. Yeah.
Now
I've done that.
I've already had to go from here over to, I'd started there, I drew that, and then I went to here. It's interesting that people watching it know more about what's going on than I do.
Yeah.
And then
me too.
I realized from here, I had to get over to the handle. But also, as I thought that, I wasn't even sure if I had drawn the handle. It suddenly occurred to me I might have drawn the handle.
Of course. Yeah, you can't remember, can you?
Twice. So what I had to do is I tried to travel down here.
Yeah.
To this side.
There's definitely a travel aspect. You try and make your way back and try and follow routes that you've already done. You've remembered where your hand was.
Now I am trying to draw.
You're doing all the detail.
I'm decided I am going to put the cavalier on, and then I'm going to go here to touch King Charles I.
I've done mine already.
Well, I think I had just done the teapot, but I might be far behind you because I'm only going to do these three figures. Here's a good element of. That's bad anyway, that I've had to do that. I've had to turn the teapot to see him because I don't know whether this plane is correct on here anyway. Shall I do a little bit of this battle on top? So I had one art tutor in particular, Max's name was, when I did my BTEC foundation.
Right.
Who liked a lot of these. He almost had a set of oblique strategies for us.
Yeah.
Would you like to hear another one of my favourites that he did?
Yes, please.
What he did, I don't know why I'm redrawing that line. I just feel like I need to reinforce that, but I have no idea why I would. He did one where we were drawing on easels, so the plane was like that. And we had to go in and take a pound of flour and tie it to our wrists. So the idea was, as we were doing the life drawing, our hands would get more and more tired as we drew, and we drew for about 2 hours. And so once again, I suppose making you think, make every mark worth it and use your eyes more. I can't think of part of this, an important part of this, which I haven't drawn.
No.
So I'm going to say I'm finished too.
I'm done.
So right. Have you looked at yours yet?
Yes, I've seen. Right. Yeah, I've looked at it now. Yeah. Yeah. I love it. I love the figures who are going off the edge of the teapot.
It's now almost a teapot, isn't it? There's this bit.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It is.
Let me
have a
look at yours.
I once did a drawing of a mug. And it was a carry-on film mug. It had a print on it. And I did it like this. And the same thing happened. The characters on the mug they lifted themselves off the mug. But I painted it and everything, and it looked really good. I think that would look good with paint.
Yours is a lot more to together as a drawing of the thing, I feel.
Do you?
What are you drawing with?
A Sharpie.
Oh, okay, nice.
Yeah.
Okay, well, there you go. There's our short video on how to do... Tell me what it's called again.
Blind contour drawing.
Blind contour drawing.
Yeah.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. There's our bite-sized tuxedo for you.
Now you do it.
Bye, Darren.
Bye, Darren.